breaking news right now. KCRA 3 has just obtained the search warrant related to the investigation into that deadly crash in Lodi that killed 6 people, all in the same family. KCRA 3's Melinda Meza is live at the San Joaquin County Courthouse in Stockton right now. Melinda, what information does this warrant have in it?
Well, the warrant does confirm the name of the man involved within this accident is 28-year-old Ryan Morales of Lodi. The warrant says he was the driver of one of the cars that was involved in this accident. It does say it tends to show a felony has been committed or that a particular person has committed a felony. Now, they did go to his home in Lodi. There they found several bottles of vodka in his motorhome and in the trash can of his motorhome. 2 found in the trash, 2 found out, 6 other bottles found in another area of the home. Now, it does say that the officer that responded to Ryan right after the collision says that he spoke with Ryan. He could smell an odor of an alcohol beverage emitting from his person. He was transported to the hospital right after that deadly accident to be treated. But at this point, it appears that he was traveling, this is according to the Lodi police, at a high rate of speed in a GMC Yukon southbound on Ham Lane when he collided with the Ford F-150, that deadly crash. And it does say here that he appears to be under the influence of alcohol while driving. Now, we did call the Lodi Police Department. They have not told us if they have arrested Ryan Morales in the hospital. They say they won't have that information for us until Monday. But according to this report, this search warrant, it says that they do believe he was under the influence of alcohol, traveling at a high rate of speed, and that they did smell alcohol on his breath at the scene of the accident. That's the latest here from the San Joaquin County Courthouse. I'm Melinda Meza, KCRA 3 News.
And Melinda, as you've been following this story all week long. So yeah. As we know, Morales is still in the hospital, and this is really the first time we've been able to confirm that that is indeed his name. At last check, are they saying that he is still in critical condition? Because he was in critical condition at one point, correct?
Yes, from my understanding, he was in critical condition and that he did, it says here that he was being treated for his injuries. We have not talked to the hospital today as of yet to find out his condition. His name was just officially confirmed just a few moments ago. We had went to the home, we had talked to relatives, but we could not get a confirmation of his name, an official confirmation that is, until just a few moments ago.
And Melinda, we're also waiting to hear from the Mexican consulate.
I could tell you that there is going to be some information today, shortly in about a half hour, at the Mexican consulate in Sacramento. I did talk to one of their representatives earlier today. She says that a family member will be speaking to the press about what is going to happen next. We could tell you that 9-year-old Eden is still in the hospital today. He did have surgery yesterday or the day before. The family says he is stable. Last report from UC Davis says that he is still listed in critical condition, however. So we talked to his godmother, and she says that her best job right now is just to make sure Eden is okay and that somebody's with him.
Poor little boy. He is the lone survivor, just as a reminder, the lone survivor in that family from that car crash. Melinda Meza, thank you for the latest information.